Hey YouTubers, how are you today? This is Ingrid from the Netherlands again, aka Rocking Lupa. And yes, it's been I think about 2 weeks ago now since I've posted my last video. And the people who watched that video, they know that that video was all about my Elvis Presley collection. And I really received so many nice responses to that. Very positive comments below the video, and you know, very kind personal messages through the email. So I'm really very grateful for that. So I really want to thank you all for that. So yeah, thanks. today a new update with some new vinyl and some new CD finds. So let's start off very quick, because I haven't had plenty of time, because and I think in about half an hour I have to get my daughter from school again. So I want to do a very quick video, okay? Well, let's start off with the CDs first. The first one I want to show you, it's by the French artist Jean-Michel Jarre. So as you see, very nice two CD set. When you open the box, you see a very nice booklet. And what's very nice about this is that the design of the disc itself, it looks like a record. So that's very nice. And so when you pull this, so you see the second disc here. So very nice to have. I wanted this CD for quite a long time. It's released already a couple of months ago. But every time I thought it's quite expensive, but now it was priced a little bit lower, so I took my chance. And Jean-Michel Jarre basically always reminds me a little bit of you know, my childhood in the 70s. Mid 70s. So, and because my grandparents, they took me to the dolphins show. We have a dolphin show here in the Netherlands, which is called Dolphinarium. It's a sort of dolphin park, and so they also have the shows there. And when I went with my grandparents to that show in the mid 70s, they played Jean-Michel Jarre in the background, you know, as a background music when during the dolphin show. So so always when I hear Jean-Michel Jarre, I always have a flashback, you know, in time, sort of, and it reminds me of my grandparents and my childhood. So in that kind of way, I think Jean-Michel Jarre, his music is kind of special to me. So I'm very happy with this purchase. And of course it's called Essentials and Rarities. The next CD I bought is by Kings of Leon. It's a very cool rock band, I think, and this CD is called Only by the Night. I already had a copy of this, but I now wanted to have the original copy. And of course it contains, among others, sorry, it's called, it's the title, but of course they it contains, among others, the title Sex on Fire and Somebody, which I think it's a very, very cool song. And Yeah, definitely great addition to my CD collection. Then I bought also a CD I already had a couple of months on a copied CD, and but now it was a very low price, so I couldn't let it go. It's Brandon Flowers. CD is called Flamingo, and of course you all know it also you can also see it on the sticker. But Brandon Flowers, of course, is the lead singer from the band The Killers. And of course this contains very nice songs, among others the hit Crossfire, a really cool song. So Brandon Flowers. Then I also bought a CD from The Killers. So Brandon Flowers is the lead singer of The Killers, and this is actually a CD from The Killers. It's called Hot Fuzz, and it also contains the track All These Things That I've Done. And maybe you I think you know that song from the, you know, they took a fragment from that song and they used that for a Nike commercial a couple of years ago for the Olympics, I think. And I was really happy I found this. The Killers. I also found another very great CD, which reminds me, of especially of the, I think end of the 80s, beginning of the 90s, when Headbangers Ball, so the TV program Headbangers Ball was on MTV. I think more people, especially 40 plus age, people about my age, they know what it is. So Headbangers Ball, that was the program, of course, which they broadcasted many hard rock bands then, and one of that bands was of course Poison, and this is the Greatest Hits album. I really couldn't let it go. It's great memories to these songs, and it contains, among others, Nothing But a Good Time, and Talk Dirty to Me, I'm Skinny Bop, Every Rose Has Its Thorn, very cool ballad, and Stand, a really great song. Look What the Cat Dragged In, Your Mama Don't Dance, really cool song. So great addition to my hard rock CDs. I already found some Soundgarden CDs a couple of weeks ago, and I already showed you that in one of my former videos. And but now I found another CD from Soundgarden again, and it's called Bad Motorfinger, and it's I think from 1991 already. So very cool addition to my Soundgarden CDs. And of course Chris Cornell, the lead singer of Soundgarden, he also had his side project for a couple of years, Audioslave. And I also found an Audioslave CD. It's called Out of Exile. I think the former CD is much better, but it has much better songs. But you know, this is also a very cool album, actually. So, Audioslave. In one of my former videos, I also told you about a German band. It's called Hartmann. And I discovered they released more CDs. They have more albums, so I also wanted to have them. And well, last week I received them through the mail. And this is Out in the Cold by Hartmann. And this is their latest release. It's called Three. also by Hartmann. And well, so it's a German band, and the lead singer of the band reminds me a little bit of David Coverdale from Whitesnake. And well, it's very nice melodic hard rock, AOR kind of music. So yeah, definitely my kind of music. So I'm very happy with this these purchases. A totally different music, but you know, I'm just I just like all kinds of music. So hard rock or a classical or R&B or soul music, it doesn't matter, you know, I just listen to everything. Last week I received this CD. It's called The Best of the Clovers. The Clovers, I just don't know how to pronounce that exactly. And they were R&B group, I think, especially in the 50s somewhere. And I really like that song, Love, Love, Love. you just should check it out on YouTube maybe, or, and well, it's very cool music. Yeah. The last CD I want to show you today, it's by a lady who passed away quite recently. Of course, I talk about Etta James. And this is the Inspirational Collection. And of course, so it contains all kinds of gospel and spiritual songs. And yeah, I really like that, besides all her, jazz and blues and all her other music. So yeah, definitely great addition to my collection. And maybe also heard in the background that I also am playing some Etta James music. It's from this LP. I already showed you this in one of my former videos. So it's Etta James Rocks the House. They're all live recordings. So yeah, very very cool LP to have. And I also bought another Etta James album, also Inspirational Greats. with other tracks than on the CD I showed you, but really great addition to my Etta James collection. And yeah, so Etta James, she passed away quite recently on the 20th of January. And yeah, of course it wasn't such a big surprise that she would pass away very soon. Of course, she had to deal with leukemia. And so it was just a matter of time, basically. And however, I think we really lost one of the biggest, really the biggest singers here in the world, maybe even in the universe, she was a great singer of the blues, soul, gospel, jazz, you name it, and she had such a strong voice, and I really have so much respect for Etta James, and it's really sad that she's gone, and rest in peace, Etta James. And happily we have so much there's so much music left here, so I could listen for hours to it. So yeah, Etta James, we will really miss her. And those were my Etta James purchases. I also have some other vinyl for you to show. The first one I want to show you, it's one of my favorite singers. It's Don Henley. Of course you know him from the Eagles. And this is one of my favorite albums. I already have it for years, really, on CD. It's Building the Perfect Beast. And of course it contains the major hit Boys of Summer. I really love that song. And I'm really happy I also have it on vinyl now. Don Henley. I also, besides a CD from Jean-Michel Jarre, I also found a really mint condition, The Essential on vinyl. I am really, really, excited. I found this. It was really cheap and, in such a perfect condition. It's really, really awesome. Yeah. I grew up in the 80s, so I also like a lot of 80s music, and I just couldn't let this record go. It's Wendy and Lisa. It's self-titled, and of course you all know Wendy and Lisa, they were from the Revolution, from Prince, Prince and the Revolution band. So a really cool addition to my collection. I also found a very cool album by Wax. It's called 100,000 in Fresh Notes. And of course with Andrew Gold, who passed away last year. So very great, very great LP. I'm a huge John Lennon fan, so John Lennon from the Beatles, of course. And I found this one. It's Sometime in New York City. It's a gatefold, so very nice pictures here. And I didn't listen to it yet, so I'm very curious what's on the album. So but I really like John Lennon, so I'm very happy with this. back to the 80s again. I found this very cool LP by Philip Oakey and George Moroder. Yes, it's self-titled. It's from 1985, so mid-80s. And it, of course, it contains the major hits Together in Electric Dreams. You should check that out on YouTube, maybe. It's really, really 80s, cool 80s music. And I think the most people will know Philip Oakey as the lead singer of Human League. So, well, really cool addition to my music collection, of course. Then I discovered this LP, and I thought it was a very cool, cool LP to have. It's by George Benson, a big bass band, featuring the Count Basie Orchestra, if I pronounce that right. So it's actually George Benson with some big band music. So yeah, I'm very curious for the LP, and I listened some small fragments on internet, and I thought it might be a very interesting LP. So yeah, I decided to give it a try. George Benson. Then I found a very cool LP. It's by the Dutch band Mother's Finest. Oh, they put the records behind in the plastic sleeve, so here you see the back side of the sleeve. Yeah, it's called Iron Age. So very cool, Mother's Finest LP. Then I found some very cool West Coast music by Orleans. This is called Before the Dance. And I also found another one, and that's called Let There Be Music. Very cool music, I think. Yeah, I really like the West Coast music, you know, Eagles and also this kind of music. It's really cool to listen to. Yeah, I also found a very cool picture disc. It's by the band Giant, and it's called Promised Land. And so you see the very nice picture of the band on the backside of the picture disc. So yeah, very cool addition to my AOR music. Yeah. Speaking of AOR music, you all know I'm such a big Journey fan, especially you know, the period with of course the lead singer Steve Perry. And I discovered there also was a 7-inch single, so Steve Perry in a duet with Kenny Loggins, and it's called Don't Fight It. There doesn't appear a picture of Steve Perry on the single, but you know, very nice to have it as well. And yeah, it's nice to hear Steve Perry again, you know. I really wish he would record some new stuff again. Yeah, we definitely miss him in the you know, in nowadays music, I think. And one of my biggest wishes actually is that he would record some new stuff again. So yeah, Steve Perry is just definitely one of my most favorite singers. Yeah. I have some other Seven Inches. And the first one, it's by Bon Jovi, Dead or Alive. Yeah, I'm such a big Bon Jovi fan. And this is Ian Gillan, and with the single Vengeance. Of course, you all know him as the lead singer from Deep Purple. And this is the last item I want to show you today. It's the 7-inch Father Figure, by George Michael. And speaking of George Michael, you all know that he has been so very ill. And there was a time they just didn't know yet if he would make it or not. And I read his Twitter account, I thought yesterday or something. And I'm so happy that, George Michael announces that he is just getting better every time and every day. And so I'm really happy and really grateful that his recovering is turning out well, you know. And because I definitely think George Michael, he is such a kind person and a great human being, and of course also a very great singer, you know. And I really hope he will take his time, take it easy. It's so very important to recover now. And of course I hope he will return on stage someday, but I don't think that's the most important thing for now, it's the most important thing for now is just getting better and getting stronger and become healthy again. So yeah. George Michael, take your time, take your rest, it's so very important, and get well. Yeah. So let's take a look at the clock. It's been 3 p.m. now, so and in about I think in 50 minutes I have to catch up my daughter from school, so I really have to quit this video here. I hope you liked my new purchases, and leave me comments again. They're very welcome, and that's all for today. Hopefully see you very soon in one of my next videos. Okay, have a great day, and have a good one. Bye bye my friends, see you the next time.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling. Yeah.